Hello everybody. Till now, we have seen and we have created a simple HTML page based on a CSS file and JavaScript in which we have already embedded some elements like hyperlink, an image, a table, and we have also formatted our table. As I have already mentioned before, tables are used for two purposes. One purpose is to build and create a simple table, the one that we have already made. Secondly, and most importantly, the tables are being used to structure the whole web page. This has some advantages. When you structure the whole web page within a table, this web page is being automatically compatible with any browser, Internet Explorer, Google Chrome, etc. So the web page has exactly the same look and feel in every browser. So let's see how this can be done. Firstly, let's take a look at our web page. This is the web page till now. We are going to go to the HTML code and insert a table that starts from here and ends here, and every individual element of this web page, like this line, this hyperlink, this image, this table, and this JavaScript code, will be inserted in discrete table rows and table dimensions. Let's see how this can be done. Firstly, we go to our code. If you have forgot how to open your code, the easiest way is to go to the web page, right click it and open it with Notepad. So this is our code. And now we will create a table exactly here, which table will end here. And we are going to create table rows and table dimensions within this huge table. For better programming purposes, gradually this will be fixed, so we can continue to our code. Do a second tier here, entity, which will be closed exactly below here. I will also incorporate the image in my table, doing the same thing. I'm repeating the same steps for each element of my website. Incorporate all the table. And of course, finally, my JavaScript program. Let's see what we have achieved. Now, all my web page is within this table here. So now, I have another advantage. I can use all the power that the table has to format my web page. Let's see what can I do. Firstly, I will align the table in the center of the web page. This can be done simply by using the align isom center attribute in the table element. Saving, refreshing. Now, as you can see, all my elements automatically have been aligned in the center of the web page. The other thing that I can do is align this image now in the center of this cell. This can be done easily again using the align attribute within the table dimension in which the image is located. Like this. I'm saving, refreshing. As you can see the advantages of the tables. We can also do the same in our JavaScript code. This can be done using the line isom center attribute in the td element which holds the JavaScript code. Let's save and see what happens to our web page. Now the JavaScript mini application is aligned in the center. Now what we can do is to remove the border equals to 1 from this table here, or set the value to 0. Save. And now our website is starting to be a bit more well structured than before. In the next mini course, we will use advanced table formatting techniques so as this web page to start to look even more pretty. And we will learn how we can do this website to have responsive characteristics. That is, when minimizing or resizing the window, all the elements, if possible, to be resized too. This is the advantage of the tables, and that's why we're trying always to structure our web pages using tables.